Hi everybody. Okay, so today I'm going to go ahead and show you what I got for $1 a day. I'll just go ahead and say this was at bin store number one. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So I found this power bank. Like I said, I got it for a dollar, and I went ahead and had them plug it in just to be sure that it worked, and it did. So I've gone ahead and charged it up. And I'm going to give this to my niece. So I'm not sure how much this will hold, but should be enough. At least it's portable, you know. I think it's better than some of those other ones that I think I've given them in the past before that were from like Five Below that are pretty kind of cheap. So yeah, give that to one of them. It's kind of funny because my mom actually convinced me to get these to sell on Mercari. So these are some Taylor Swift pillows. There are two of them, and they come with a keychain. So yeah, I got this for a dollar. So here is the keychain. So it says, I'm a Swiftie. I love TS. And then it has a little keychain of Taylor Swift. Get a good shot of it. I don't know if you can see it. It looks like her head is being covered. I'm trying to make sure that it's in focus. This is not focusing. I don't know what's going on. Okay. So I will try to sell these, but not right now because I've noticed that there are some on there that people are selling. I found this. So this is a Lectorman notebook. It's funny because it is all in German. It's a B5 size and it's lined. I've never had one of these types of notebooks before, but I've always heard about them. So for a dollar, I thought I'd just give it a try. I do wish it wasn't as, you know, so big, but that's okay. I don't know. We'll see. I might give it to my sister if she likes it because she does a lot of lettering. It's like her side hustle. I found this. This is a pack of five, face masks. And this one is a calming repair mask. So let me see here. It is Korean. I didn't look it up yet on Amazon, but this is what it looks like. And it is pretty full there, as you can see. So I think this would probably be good when there's like, when I have like a breakout and can try that. I might give one to my other sister so she can try it out. Let's see what else. I did find this. This was interesting. So it is a case of pens. Now, each of the pens has like I don't know if it's like a felt tip. Where, I don't even know if this is actually focusing because I don't hear it focusing. Huh, hold on one second here. Okay, for some reason, this camera was set to to manual focus. So let's see, yep, there we go. It's focusing now. So it has like a felt tip. Not a felt tip, I guess it's, I don't know. Let me see, because I did test it out, but I didn't test out the pen part of it. I tested out the other part. So I'll show you. Came with some stickers, which was kind of strange. So this is what one of the pens looks like, right? And one end is, okay, so it's kind of like a Sharpie end. And then the other end is like this. So it's a roller and each of them have a different design. So these are the different designs that they have. I've seen these before, not this particular one, but I've seen they've sold like other sets before like this. And I just kind of passed them up. But this time I thought I'll give it a try because it did have more designs than the ones I've seen in the past. So we'll see how that works out. That'll be interesting to use for like in the memory journal. I had a hard time trying to put this back, so that's why I kind of left it like that. I'm going to give this to my sister because she does like inner gels. I like them too. And that was $1. I found, it's kind of funny, I had ordered the switch puller and the keycap puller, and then I find a set of them. So it's always good to have because I always misplace them. This one right here, this is for, what do you call it? It's for your brows. Hold on. Let me get this out of the bag. So it is, brow gel, and I've never heard of this brand, but it should be interesting. Let me see how fine this is. I hope there's something in there. Don't tell me I paid $1 for an empty box. I mean, the bag was sealed, so, oh, there it is. There we go. Arches and halos. So I'm going to try this and see how it will set my brows, my brow powder. It's a very, very thin. I've never seen a tip this thin before. So we'll just give it a try for $1. I used to get, I think it was it Elf? Back in the day when they used to sell their stuff for just $1. I used to use that to set my brows, but didn't seem to hold very well. I was happy to see this because I always use this St. Ives Acne Control Scrub. I always got to have that. And I was about to run out too, so it was really good timing. Now, it's kind of funny. As you've seen in the past, and I've showed it, they do sell food items. And I saw this. They had the Kraft Goodness. I've never had the Green Goddess dressing, so I'm just curious how it's going to taste. I'm just looking at the sugar, so it's not too bad. So yeah, going to give that a try. Not bad for just $1. What else here? Oh, and this was the best find, actually, all day. Let me move this out of the way. So I was finally able to find scrapbook stuff. And when I picked this up, I saw this and I was like, oh, I know exactly what that is. This actually, I had found something else prior to this. They were like sticky notes, really cute sticky notes, but I kind of just threw them in my cart. And then, you know, it was when I was quote unquote editing my cart before I was going to pay for everything. I noticed that the sticky notes were all like Bible verse related. And I was just like, I don't want that. So I had to put those back. But these was definitely a really good find. So there's four, and I opened up one, and there's like different designs. But what's interesting is that it's front and back designs. I've never seen that before. It's usually just, you know, one-sided. So we have here Flora Collect is what it's called. And that's volume one, right? So you see this. And when I open it up, they're different. There's different papers in here, different designs. But like I said, front and back, right? So you get two of each. And they're beautiful. So the great thing is that, you know, they're in different colors as well. So this one obviously is shades of blue. Okay. And then we have this one here. This is more of like, it says medieval rose. Let's trying to see where I can open this. Oh yeah, definitely medieval. We have volume three here, which is, it doesn't say really, I guess retro collect. Well, no, because that says it on the other one as well. what the theme is called. Has that paper smell. And the last one here, volume 4. What is that? It's at the bottom here. Really, really pretty. The dragonfly. So I'll definitely have fun using this for my junk journal collage work. I think this will work well with like the tags since they're a little bit bigger. I don't want to really waste it on, what do you call this, on the ATC cards so much because, you know, it's kind of an off size and, yeah. So I definitely want to use that with the tags. Okay. And the last things that I found, this was at a different store and it was also $1 a day. So these are switches. Keyboard switches. Whoops. So I knew the brand, and when I saw this, I knew exactly what it was. So it's Aiko, and it's the Cream Blue Pro. I don't think these are lubed, but they were all intact. In fact, this one I saw had already been opened. They probably were just curious, whoever opened it. And that's why I always find switches, because people just, you know, shop at these stores, they don't have any idea what it is. So, yeah, they're all intact. There's like 45 in a pack. And so, I was just curious. I just wanted to try it out, see what, these type of switches were like, since I was lucky enough to find the other ones. Was it last week? I think. And I think I found that pack for $1 as well. And then what this, so I found this like in the second table or third table and then, or bin. And then later on towards the end, I found another pack, but it didn't have the cover, but they're still all intact. So I've got a total of 90 switches. So that'll work with one of my bigger keyboards. So I'm going to try those out as well. So that's all the things that I got for $1 a day. And I'll be back to show you what I get on $1 a day on Thursday at another store. All right. I'm back, everyone. All right, so it's Thursday, and the last store that I go to in the week, it's Dollar Day. So I'm going to go through the stuff that I got. They had a lot of good stuff, so I actually bought more than I usually get on Dollar Day. So I saw this. This box was already open, and there's a set of 6 bowls. 2, 4, 6. Yeah, these are made out of bamboo, and I just thought that they would look really cute to house, like, you know, my rings, my earrings, my necklaces, on my vanity or something like that. They're just really adorable. And I like that they're made out of bamboo. I kind of wish that they did have like some cute design, but I don't know. It's okay. That'll work. And I got, like I said, 6 for $1. Not bad, eh? So let's put this in the trash. I got this. Actually, I did get one like this, but I'm going to keep that one and give this one to my niece. I've already shown it to her, and she wants this one instead, because the other one that I got, this is a shampoo brush massager, scalp massager. I have short, like, pixie hair, and she's got really long, thick hair, being that she's 13. She's going to be turning 13, so this will probably be better for her. So her birthday is next month, as is mine. But she's a Gemini and I'm a Cancer. We're only apart by 4 days. I'm sorry. So anyways, this was on her birthday list and she told me to just, you know, put it with all her other presents. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. What else we got here? Okay. So I'm also going to give her this this is a book light, since it's now the start, you could say, of like, well, it's not really the start, it's all year round, storm season. The power goes out, and it's out for quite a while. She can use this when she wants to read her books. It's a book light, and it's nice because it's pretty bright, and you can change the type of light, and you can increase the, you can increase it as well, or decrease it. And it's rechargeable. Where is that? Oh, you can also turn it too. That's weird. Where's the charge? Where is it for you to charge? Because I know that it said that. Yeah, there's the cap. So the charging pin is right there. So somehow I have to know how to do this because I got to show it to her. Hold on. There it is. So she can plug it in and charge it. So, and it's in her favorite color, purple. Or as, oh wow, it even bends down like that too. That's actually really nice. Too bad I didn't find another one. And this is obviously brand new. So that is going to be for her. All right. I found one of these. At least this one was not messed up, so it can definitely, I mean, it wasn't cracked or anything, so it can store some ephemera. I mean, there's a crack there, but it's not too bad. So, not bad for a dollar. I always need containers like that. This, obviously, is, I don't think this is going to be 100 pieces, because it was open like this, but these are cable clips, so I'm going to use them for, like, putting the charging cables to kind of line them up so they're not all over the place. I just thought that was a really good one for a dollar. Now, I'm glad that I was able to find four of these, because I showed you last week that I got several of these also. So these are those earplugs. And the good thing is that these have not been opened. I think only one of them has, but this one's unopened. That's unopened. This is the only one that was open, but I made sure that everything was in it. So that's white. And then I'm going to take this one out of the bag, because I don't ship them in the bag like that, because it's going to say that it was a return. But I believe this one is unopened as well. When I look, kind of look through the bag. Yeah, this is unopened. And this one is Celestial Equinox. And this one is like a much darker green like this. Much, much darker. Almost like a teal, but more green. And I have one of these. It's my favorite color. So definitely going to be able to sell those again. I've been lucky. I've been able to sell them for more than $20. Considering I'm only buying from $1. I found this. I thought this would have been funny to have. This would have been really good to have when I was still working at the clinic, because these are keyboard covers. So there are three of them in there. And I think they use them like at the hospitals. I've seen them cover the keyboards up, you know, to prevent germs, but this is also to help avoid spills and stuff like that. I mean, for a dollar and you get three of them, it's not bad. If my mom wants to keyboard for her laptop, an external keyboard, I can put one of these on there. She's more likely to like spill some liquid or something on it. Now, this was kind of an impulse buy. I mean, my sister has a dog. It's a golden doodle. This is a happy hoodie. I've seen this used on YouTube, the Girl with the Dogs channel. She's a groomer, a dog groomer, or just a groomer in general. I think she's in Toronto, and she uses these on the dogs and cats that she grooms. But this is obviously for a dog, and I did not bring this with me when I went to my sister's house to try it on her dog. So you cover, basically you're using it to cover their ears so they don't get freaked out when you're blow drying them, after, you know, giving them a bath. So I always wondered about these. I didn't know it was an actual product. I thought it was just maybe something that she had came up with. But yeah, so it's kind of like a snood, I guess you could say, for dogs. So if I go to her house, I'm going to try it on him and see. So that way, you know, when they give him bath during the summertime and they have to blow dry him, at least they can try using that so he's not going to freak out. Okay, so I saw this and it was in a bag. See, these are the little things that people just ignore. They don't even bother to really look. And that's how I'm able to find like the really good stuff. They just go for the big boxes and, you know, things that are like really, really obvious. But this is a SanDisk Ultra. And this is a 1 gig micro SD card. So I could technically use this like in my tablet or my phone if I wanted to, because my phone does still take external memory cards. But, you know, always good to have this kind of stuff, because you never know when you're going to need a micro SD. I'm going to see if I can use it even on my camera. Okay, so this thing here, I wasn't exactly sure what it was until I took it out of the bag. But I know I'd seen this before. So it's a travel container. So this one here, you can put like the liquids, like shampoo and body wash. So there's only two. And obviously if I take these clips off, you'll be able to like pump it. So it looks like it already even has the labels on the side. This one says shampoo. And then this one says body wash. So, and it's just in this cute little container, just like that. It's good that it has a cover, you know, so if there's a leak, it should keep it from getting all over your stuff. Yeah, I think there's two in here. So I've found this before. It was yellow, in fact, and I gave one to my mom. So these are key covers. I've seen these on Temu. I think it was advertised on Temu because I kept showing up on my Instagram feed. But basically, and I like the little bunny design on there. So it's all the way up in there. There we go. So you just put your keys on here and then you can just pull this and then it'll keep your keys all stored in here. You know, so they're not scratching up your glass sunglasses and your purse or whatnot, but it's adorable, isn't it? Two for a dollar. I know if my mom sees this, she's going to want to get one again. I'm like, I already gave you one and she's not even using it, which is kind of annoying. So I'm like, why did you even take one then if you're not going to use it? Yeah. Cause I have an older car, so I don't have like a key fob or anything like that where, you know, you can unlock your car by just pressing a button. Yeah, mine doesn't have that. I'm going to use that car until it basically just dies. There's no point in like buying a new car. Cars are expensive these days. So this one here, these are planner stencils. There are, and it's numbered too. I think there's 12. Yeah, there are 12 stencils. So you got block schedules and shopping list. This one here for exercise, finance. We've got the months. This, the weather. Weekly. We've got the letters. More of that. We've got banners and stuff, boxes, that. Now, I've got some of those Dollar Tree binder rings, so I'm going to put one on there. I did find another set of, what do you call these? I'm sorry, I'm tired. They're not stencils. They are, oh gosh, I can't even think. But they've got like, they're like for geometry and stuff. And there was like a set of maybe about six of them. And I gave them over to my niece today when she came by. So that's why I don't have it here to take a pic. I mean, to show you on camera. So this right here is a magnetic poster hanger frame. There is a particular poster that I have not put up yet, a movie poster, a film poster, that I got signed when I was in San Francisco last time that I'm going to use this on. And so this is great because it just looks like this, right? But the magnets are on the inside. So this is the bottom, and then this one is the top. So I can just hang the poster. I think this is a great idea. So I don't have to go and just like get, you know, buy a frame and put it in the frame. I can just hang it that way. So we got that. And the exciting find, the only thing is that it was obvious that there probably might have been like another set here when I found this, but I looked all over that bin and I didn't find it. I looked in the next bin thinking maybe they moved it. No. So I was only able to get this. Hopefully when I go back for 50 cent day, maybe the rest of them will show up, but they'll probably be individual pieces, which is still okay. Cause if I'm able to find individual pieces, at least it's only 50 cents. So these look like, it says vintage stickers, right? So let me see. I didn't open these up when I was in the store because I had so many things that I put in my bag. It was weird being able to find all this stuff on $1 day that it took me some time to go through it all, edit my bag or cart, so to say. So I knew what these were, so I didn't bother to like actually open them. So they're just vellum pieces of like rooms. Okay. So it's really nice. This is obviously fall. So that would look really nice on a planner spread. You know, you want to fill up a space, an empty spot that you didn't maybe write in. This one is probably the same. It's like garden. And then this one here, it's probably in the porch. So I'm excited that I was able to find that for a dollar. Let me see. 80 pieces. So it looks like there are some missing because it says 80 pieces. And there's, I don't know how many are in here. I can't read because I don't have my readers. I'm pretty sure that there's missing packets that'll just show up. Yeah, I don't know why I haven't been able to find much scrapbook stuff lately. It just hasn't shown up. Okay. So this one here is a USB flash drive, and it is 1 gig, I think. So it has the adapter here, okay, for USB-C. So this is it right there. It's, 1 terabyte. I'm sorry, not 1 gig, 1 terabyte. What am I saying? This one is also, this has got to be one. Yeah, this has got to be 1 terabyte then. Okay. Like I said, I'm tired. So it also has lightning. So you could probably move all of your files from your phone as well with this. Same thing with this. Like if you have an Android phone, I think that's really what this is intended for, is to move those files, you know, quick and easy. So great deal for $1. Like I said, a lot of people don't look at all the little stuff and they're just looking for all that big stuff. Okay. So we don't need to show that because I've already shown that. I'm trying to save like the biggest piece here. I guess it's the last one because I don't see anything else. Okay. So the last one that I got was a mouse pad. And yeah, I try not to buy these anymore because I have a lot of them, but I could sell them. I'm going to maybe think about selling some of the ones that I have. A Macari, but this one's really pretty because it's like oil. It's like an oil painting and you can see how large and long it is. So it's not the white, it's not the whitest or the tallest, but this'll do. I use these a lot when I was working at the clinic, simply because I hate using those smaller, pads. And then I always run out of room. Okay. Sorry, somebody was texting me. All right. So I think that is everything. Yeah, let me make sure again. Look at my bag. Because I only have my gloves. And yep, that is it for Thursday, so I'll be back again to show you what I got for 50 cent day. All right, I am back. It is Friday, 50 cent day. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what I got. It wasn't a lot. I only got two things. So the first thing I did find was these are the pre-cut adhesive patches for the Libre 3. Now, Libre 3 is a glucose monitoring sensor, and I've used it in the past. I still have like a ton, probably like 3 months worth left of it, but I stopped using it because I was having problems with the stupid thing, getting recognized by my phone, because you use it. It's like a Bluetooth, so you can use the app and then it will tell you what your glucose reading is. And I probably went through four of them and it just wouldn't read for some reason. And I've been using them for like, 4 months. So I switched over to a different sensor, which is the Dexcom 7. And my insurance actually at the time was covering the Dexcom, but not the Libre. It wasn't formulary anymore. So it worked out. I was able to change. But anyways, with the Dexcom, it's a little bit bigger sensor and it doesn't stick as well as the Libre's did. But anyways, long story short, you get these. So actually, this is a little bit different. I have some covers that you would put. So this is the sensor. This is actually the size of the sensor. And you would put this over the sensor to keep it from falling off. Because, sweat, showering, the adhesive is going to loosen up and you have to wear this on your arm or for about 2 weeks, 14 days. With the Dexcom, you wear it for 10 days. With the Dexcom, I'm noticing that the adhesive ring that I have to put over the sensor is starting to peel off after like the second day, which is kind of crazy. I mean, the sensor is on my skin pretty well, but I don't want to risk it getting loose. So I've had to put, these adhesive covers over it. And I saw these, there's 20 in a pack. Now the one that I have that I purchased from Amazon a while back, that has, I think 50. And then I found another pack of these a couple weeks ago. I think it's the same one. I don't know. I'm gonna have to check. And then I found these again today for 50 cents. So let's see. Oh, okay. This is kind of strange. I'm gonna have to look this up on Amazon. Actually, no, I won't have to because here are the instructions. Okay. Huh. So pull the corner, detach from the patch, place it around the transmitter, rub the white backing 3 times, then peel off the white backing. Ah, that is interesting. This probably is not going to work because I know that this is the size. It's sized specifically for the Libre 3. Damn it. Well, that's okay because one of my mom's friends is switching to the Libre 3 instead of having to do finger pricking, which I don't know why people want to do that when you can just get the sensor, stick it on your arm, and be done with it. So she's switching over, and I've got to teach her how to use it. So I'm going to give her these. So, I didn't really spend a lot. I only spent 50 cents. Hey, and if I keep finding them and if she likes these, I'll just tell her that I'll just, pick them up for her. So the second thing that I found, I think I did see this yesterday, but now you're probably wondering, why did you buy that? The solar eclipse has passed. Yes. So the solar eclipse has passed. This came with 5, I believe, but I can donate these because I remember them publishing or posting on Facebook, that they are collecting all of the used ones to send to South America for the school children down there because they're going to be having a total eclipse, I think, next year, maybe. So, I'll go ahead and just donate these. Let me see. So I think I can drop them off at American Optics. So American Optics is the company that made a lot of these for the eclipse, and they are actually located here in my hometown. So yeah, I'll probably donate that. What I wanted was this. This is what I used actually for taking pictures of the eclipse with my cell phone. I ordered it actually from Amazon, and I have no idea where I put it now. And I kind of want to have it on hand because if I ever want to take pictures of the sun itself, like if they ever were able, you know, if there's another solar storm, so to say, I can use a longer lens on my camera and use that. Now, I'll just show you an example of what it was like when I used. Okay, so here it is. Here's some pictures. These are pictures that I took with using this. So all I did was just place it right over and then, kind of zoomed in and I was able to take the pictures of the eclipse. So that's actually a good one right there. But let me see if I can get, see, there's the start, kind of the start. Actually, no, here's the start. Yeah. So that's using this filter. It's pretty easy, you know, but that's the only reason why, like I said, I'm going to keep this in my camera bag. So I always have it on hand. So that's all that I got for 50 cent day. There just really wasn't a lot. The bins were a little empty, either that, or I just really picked up everything I wanted yesterday on $1 day. So we'll start this process again next week and I'll go back to one of the stores on Tuesday. That's going to be at $1 and I'll film again. So I'll see you guys on the next video. All right. Bye.